Absolute Beauty on Facebook last night, post from Lad Bible, and they were talking about the origins of your nickname. But I'm going to read a few of these out for you. Jay, you haven't seen any of these. I've hidden them from you. My dad had a mate who's got half his ear missing, and his nickname is 18 months because he's only got an ear and a half. had a boss called Drillbit because he's a small, boring tool. Richard Henderson writes, I worked with a guy who had one big hand and one small hand. He was known as the Clock. Darren Allen writes, I knew a fella whose nickname was Uncle Ben's because he had a cyst removed from his sack. A boil in the bag. Mark O'Brien. Mark O'Brien writes, worked in a factory and there was this guy called Keith there. Took me ages to realise that his real name was Keith, but he had an eye missing. And then one final one as well. This is from Lab Bible. Oh. There's a guy at work that has one leg shorter than the other, which causes his head to bob side to side. So they call him the Sniper's Nightmare.
Brody Holdaway writes, my boss's nickname is Noodle because he thinks every job should take 2 minutes. Spencer Rose writes, my nickname's Crab Sticks because I fell asleep on a very hot day, not realizing my legs were not covered by the shade of the tree that I was sleeping under. Front leg sunburnt red, the back of the leg still snow white. Andy Holland said he worked with a guy called Donkey, and initially I thought he may have been built like one or hung like one. So I asked him why the boss calls him Donkey. He replied, he always calls me that. Tom Stratford writes, we call my mate who has bad acne. He's called the clumsy beekeeper.
That's so brutal.
Jay Ollie writes, I nicknamed one of my mates Blister because he said he always turns up after the hard work is done. Brendan Murphy says, I work with a bloke we call Glass Eye. He looked effective but didn't do much. One final one here. Shane Benson writes, work with a guy called Two Cocks because you got to have two cocks to be that much of a wanker. This is Nicknames Part 3.
This from Michaela Gunn. I work with a bloke called Beer Bottle because he's empty from the shoulders up.
That's good.
Dave Livo. My mate's nickname was Tail Light because he wasn't bright enough to be a headlight. Paul Day. I know twins that were called size 6 and 7 because that's the biggest size eggs that you can get. Aku Tudea. I know a guy whose nickname is Lantern because he's always got to be carried at work and he's not too bright.
That's a good one.
Gary Chicoach. We call the boss Mortgage Eyes because one's fixed and the other one's variable. And Jay Plunkett. I know a bloke called Edname, so his nickname was June. End of May, June.
God, they're a feature.
And this is a pretty grim one. We work with a bloke in the UK. All the lads called him Simba. I thought it was because he took over running the family business. Turns out the real reason he got the nickname was because, just like the movie, his uncle killed his dad.
Oh!
The Rock, taking the piss since 91.
I found this post by someone sending it to me, and it's off a Facebook page called the Awesome Boilies page. They simply asked, who's got an apprentice at work? What do you call him? Randall Else writes, we've got a bloke we call Cane Toe because every time he stops, he sits down. Steve Roberts writes, there's a bloke at our work called Honey because he's thick, but he's also sweet. Darren Lawrence reckons he's got a bloke at his work called Never Sweat. Never worked hard enough to work up a sweat. Dean says, not a nickname, but not a apprentice nickname, but I call my workshop the nursing home because every time I look out there, it's like watching the elderly move around. Wayne Manton calls his apprentice Stink Finger because he won't pull his finger out of his ass. Matt Martin writes, he's got an apprentice called Bush Ranger, always holding everyone up. Kobe Smith says at his work there's a bloke called Foreskin because he disappears when the work gets hard. And Jesse Grummett writes, there's a bloke, a useless bloke at our work called Cordless. You charge him up all night and he only does about 2 hours work the next day. And my favourite from Rod D, we've got a bloke at our work called Contagious because it takes the contagious to do anything. We've got an apprentice bricklayer called James Bond, as in 007, zero talent, zero effort, seven poos a day. I used to work with a bloke, we called him Toes, because that's all you can see hanging out of the boss's ass. That's how far up he is, you beauty. Or Jay, is that we yet? He's called Anteater because he has an extremely long... Oh, we can't read that on the radio. Bloke at the pub, he's known as the judge because he handles a case a day. Good on you, mate. Michael O'Brien, Miss Just saying he's got a mate at work they call Pothole because you spend the whole day trying to avoid him. The wicket keeper puts on gloves and then stands out back. There's a bloke here at work that we're calling Grenade at the moment because we're just waiting for him to pull the pin. There's a guy at our work called Sensorlight. Only works if someone walks past. Seaweed floats around all day and stinks. There's a guy at our work called Penguin. He's always on the ice. That's so rough. G-spot, you can never find him. Two-stroke. Hard to get started and always smoking. And one final nickname, Harvey Norman. He's been there 3 years and he's got no interest.
We've got Mr. 501 at 1 minute past five. He'll be long gone.
Yes. Mudguard, shiny on top, but all shit underneath.
We've got a foreman we call the Flexbush. When he gets into a huff, starts flapping his arms around like a bush in the wind.
We've got a boss here in Aussie that's got a wandering eye. We call him Sports Bet because he's got one going each way.
We've got a bloke in our scheme called the Spider because he last went shopping in the 90s and bought himself four pairs of jeans. We had a guy at uni called the General. When he walked into the pub, the whole rugby club stood to attention and saluted. Called him it for 4 years, then convinced him to get the General tattooed on his ass. Then he went and walked into the bar, the whole club would go to sleep. It's because he's a general anesthetic to a conversation and bores you to sleep. It was a 4-year stitch up. The boys got him!
That's ruthless. Over here in Aussie, a bloke I once worked with, he was called Dicto. After a month or so, I asked another colleague why this fellow was called Dicto. He goes, oh, that's because his gut sticks out further than his Dicto. Danny King says worked at the freezing works with a guy who used to process all the blood from the animals. He was always covered in blood, so he nicknamed him Tampax.
Sam Koperman. One of my dad's mates was telling him he had a friend at school. His name was Graham Grahams, so they called him Echo.
That's good. Taylor Cameron writes, I've got a good one for you. My brother has a workmate they call Mufasa because he needs to move faster. Like that.
Mandy Bonnie texts in, I have a friend that lost three toes, so he's now known as the Dream Man because he has a foot and a half down there.
Mike Han writes, I worked with a bloke called Berry Berry. He couldn't pronounce the letter V properly when he said a word. starting with the letter V. He slurred it so much it sounded like a B. I finally asked the boss, why Berry Berry? He goes, deadpan, look right at me and says, haven't you realised he is Berry Berry useless?
This one to wrap it up from Steve Yo. My mate's boss is called the paramedic. He comes in, stitches everyone up, and then leaves just as fast as he came.
You want one more?
You got one more?
I got one more. Scott Baker writes, we've got a guy with the nickname Caesar, for the short for Caesarian. He disappears every single night when we have to push the cars back into the workshop.
Too proud to push.
Oh, thank you. As always, you want to send them to us, you can do that. Send it to the Rock Drive Facebook page. Nicknames round 5 or 6. I'm losing count. Had a sales rep whose nickname was Jetboat because he had no sales. Our senior B's assistant rugby coach is called Driftwood. Suddenly he appears, floats around, does bugger all, then disappears. Dan Candy says, our workmate, we call him Pokeball, as in Pokemon. He takes off his hard hat to show his bald white head and his big red beard. When you a bloke with a very unfortunate set of cross eyes, we called him Chip and Dip. One eye on the chip, one eye on the dip. My dad nicknamed my mate Nine Iron because he has a club foot. We would have only been about 8 at the time, but it stuck to this day.
Nine Iron's a badass nickname.
That's a cool-ass nickname.
And
it's much better than Chip and Dip.
Worked with a bloke that looked way older than he was. Tan, leathery skin. Only ever wore jandals, so I started calling him the 5 o'clock chicken. You know when you go to the chicken shop and there's that one last burnt shriveled specimen that's been spinning away all day? The 5 o'clock chicken, everyone. Shout out to Thrush. Apparently someone's called Thrush, guys. Next, we're getting down to the bottom of an argument.
I thought you were going to finish off why he's got the nickname.
Nope, absolutely not. Lose my job.
My mate's girlfriend used to drive us around everywhere and she has a missing toe, so we call her the tow truck. Rosie Smith, we had an old bloke that worked with us. We called him Sooner. The sooner he effed off, the better.
Daniel Leatham writes, I play cricket with a bloke that's always getting injured, so his nickname is Tampon because he's in for a week and out for 3.
We work with a bloke in Canberra that we called the Giver. He thought it was great and reflected on how hard he works until I told him it's because hearing his voice gives me a headache, watching him attempt to work gives me stress, and just looking at him gives me the shits.
James Humphrey says, we have an environmental officer at work called Seagull. He flies in, flaps his wings, squawks a lot, shits on everyone, then buggers off. Matty Clark has a mate. He's cross-eyed. He's called Mortgage. He's got one eye fixed and the other one's floating.
Gary Crook. We work with a bloke who we call the Appendix because he is absolutely no use at all to anybody and we've been trying to get him taken out for years. My boss calls me the computer. It's got nothing to do with intelligence. I just go to sleep if unattended for 15 minutes.
Oh, that's good. I've got a mate called Car Wash because his ass cheeks are so hairy that when he drops his shorts and bends over, he looks like one. And one final one here from Glenn Douthwaite. I told my mate I thought I saw his name on a loaf of bread the other day, but when I looked again, it said thick cut.
I thought we were done. Oh, we're clearly not.
This is Nicknames Volume 8.
Davey Williams, I know a set of twins where one of them accidentally got shot in the leg. They're known as Leaded and Unleaded.
Used to work on a building site with a guy called Luke, who walked around all day trying to skive off work. We named him Luke Sightwalker.
I almost picked that before you said it. That's good.
I named my stepdaughter's boyfriend Handbag because he has no personality and just carries her stuff for her. That's changed now. He's got a new nickname now that she ran over him and shattered his leg. He's called Roadkill.
I call my mate Belly Button because he's 37 and lives at home with his mum still. He's never been detached from the umbilical cord.
Belly Button.
We've got a mate who never buys a round. His nickname is Crime because crime doesn't pay.
These are so good.
We used to have a guy at work and we called him Glovebox because he was full of shit and you couldn't shut him up. Bloke I work with is called Fitz Hall. His name was One Size. One Size Fitz Hall.
Ben Dundee, we nicknamed a bloke at work Rapper because the line he was working on was shrink wrapping double pallets of 25 kilo bags. Started to build up, and when he went to check on them, he discovered that he'd been wrapped up himself.
Bloke at work called Radar because he didn't do any work until the boss came in and he could always hear his car arrive and then started working. I work with a guy called Amen because he always had to have the last word. And one final one for you. My mate has a stutter and he introduced himself to everyone that I've seen him introduce himself to as Remix.
Oh, mate, we thought we were done with it. We thought that we'd heard it all, but it just keeps coming in.
An absolute treat, and no doubt there'll be another one. You little beauty.
Jay
and Dunc,
lovely.
Thanks, Cameron, for your message. I work with a guy we call Denzel, meaning Denzel non-Washington, because once he got caught not washing his hands after taking a cack. We had a dude at work that we called Goldilocks. On our first Friday afternoon, he could only handle 3 beers. We're on here.
Taylor Oakes, I've got a mate that we call Traction Control because he always kicks up a fuss when things go sideways. I work with a bloke who walked with a gimpy leg whose nickname was Kadonk. I asked him why. He told me it's the sound they made when the truck hit him. I've got a mate we call a mate whose real name is Richard Ferguson, so his nickname is the Dick Tractor.
We have a carpenter.
With this one, I got a workmate who had really bad skin, lots of pimples all over his face, absolute shambles of a human. His nickname was the Clumsy Beekeeper. And finally, from Scotty Kent, we've got a bloke that we work with who was born with
Rock.
Jay
and Dunc. Lovely.
I work with a guy called Dave, who was the factory snitch, so we nicknamed him Dave Dobbin.
I want to add to the nicknames, as I worked a bloke that looked a lot older than he actually was, Jay.
What is my new nickname?
Had that many creases in his face, we called him Fossil Head.
Hey, Fossil Head, how you going?
We have a guy at work we call Full Term, because that's how pregnant he looks.
I knew a bloke called Nemo. He was born with one arm half the size of his other.
Oh my gosh.
Two guys who had nicknames. One was the Rucksack and the other one was Man Bat. I asked how they got their nicknames and the boss said, one's full of useless shit and everyone carries him. And the other one's real name's actually Wayne Bruce. So of course he's going to be called Batman. I had an old workmate that used to be called Snow Globes. When he got pissed off with the computer, he would pick up his monitor and shake it like a Christmas snow globe. Michael Crediton said, I went to a school with a guy we called Slinky because every time you looked at him, you just wanted to push him down the stairs.
I was working at a pub in Cork, Ireland, with a bloke whose nickname was Miss Ireland. Couldn't figure out why, because he wasn't the best looking bloke. Turns out he was into parachuting and missed the drop zone and ended up in the sea. Missing Ireland. See, we had no more. And we were wrong. Thank you very much to everyone that sent those in.
Oh, definitely the last time we're doing that, though.
Yeah, 100%.
100% the last time. Yeah, that definitely won't be back. I don't think that could. You can't top that. But that won't be back.
Jay
and Dunc,
Lovely.
Welcome to Nicknames Volume 10. We've got a guy that works with us. His surname is Brothwood. So we started calling him Soup, as in soup broth. Anyway, we soon discovered that he wasn't the brightest spark, and we decided to call him Stew because he got thicker over time. My neighbour's name is Peter, and he has an identical twin brother. Peter was the firstborn, so he's Pete, and his brother is called Repeat.
We have an older bloke around 60 at work as well. He has really bad flaky skin. The boys call him Snowflake, and the ute drives the snow globe. When he drives around with the windows down, it looks like he's vaping.
Jeez, that's some flaky-ass skin.
A mate who lost an eye at work and now is known as Headlights. His one eye dips and the other dazzles.
I have a mate who works in the Royal Air Force. We call him Biscuits because he crumbles under the slightest bit of pressure. Shout out to Biscuits. Good to have you listening, mate. I work with an old boy here in the Middle East. He leans forward quite a lot when he slowly moves around. His nickname's Photo Finish. He looks like he's leaning out to break the finishing line tape. I have a colleague that is an absolute teabag. As it happens, his name is also Earl, and he has grey hair. Insert nickname, Earl Grey.
Work with a bloke we called the Submarine Door because he's thick as fuck. I once were the bloke we call the pinata, because whenever this bloke was around, you wanted to smack him with a stick. Met a bloke the other day. His name is Richard Maple. His nickname, Dick Syrup.
I know a guy whose name is Matt. He picked up the nickname Carpet because he's too thick to be a mat. We have a guy called The Ornament. He might be interesting occasionally, but generally he's pretty useless. A shrimp is the nickname. Went on a lad's holiday to Turkey. We'd all been hard out on the ales and eaten some dodgy kebab. The fella in question was sunbathing on his front wearing a pair of hideous budgie smugglers. He tried to fart, but it ended up being a shark, which shot a thin line of poo out of his smugglers in a perfect line up his spine, which kind of looked like the digestive tract of a shrimp. Nicknames, Volume 12. My dad had a friend at school. His name was Graham Graham, so they called him Echo.
Had an Irish manager in our rugby team we named Cadbury because after a glass and a half, he was glassy-eyed and ranting about Brian O'Driscoll's tackle in the Lions Series 2005. Cheers, Andy.
So I have a mate who knows where all the takeaways are. No matter where we are, we call him the Fat Nag.
A mate, Corey, who was drunk as a skunk, broke my toilet at a party, fell on it while trying to sit down for a poo. Smashed the bowl in half. He now goes by the nickname Shitter Splitter.
Got a bloke that we play rugby with called the Florist because he never travels with the boys and he always makes his own arrangements to get to the games.
It's always heck.
My mate works for a roofing firm here in Donegal, Ireland. His boss keeps falling off roofs, so they nicknamed him Superman. Not because he survived falling off so many roofs, but because he thinks he can clearly fly.
Damien Lewis writes, we have a mate from cricket who has Parkinson's. His nickname is Skill Tester. He reckons watching him trying to pick up something is like watching the claws on a skill tester.
And finally from me, Jeff Peck. I used to work with someone called the Tow Truck because he stressed a lot and looked like he was heading for a breakdown.
Rowan Toms writes, got a mate at cricket. He's lost four toes in a work accident a few years ago. We call him Milky because he's lactose. Nicknames will be back 100%. You should see the list that we have.
The Rock, taking the piss since 91.
Right, let's get into it. This is Nicknames, Volume 13. Jay, you're in for a treat here. Okay, this go. Is from Stav from Wagga Wagga, Australia. I work with a bloke that was that thick. When you asked him to do anything, he'd sit and stare at you in silence for a minute or two, so we called him Remembrance Day. Anthony Jones from Wales.
Wales!
We've got a guy at work called Terry Hurd, and we call him Hairy Turd. His son started working at the same place, so we call him the Fluffy Poo. Terence Friel. We had a boss who had a limp due to football. One of the guys called him the man with the stone in his shoe. George Morley writes, thought I'd share a nickname of a bloke at our cricket club. He hasn't taken a catch in five seasons that he's played for us. We call him Lemsip because he couldn't catch a cold. Brad Atherton writes, I work with a guy nicknamed Upgrade because he got circumcised at the age of 28. Reckons his wife has never jumped him so much. Good to have you listening, Upgrade. Daniel Lovelock, I used to work with a guy called Derek Haycock. I had no idea what his real name was for years because everyone just called him Strawballs. Nigel Campbell says, worked in town, there was a bloke named Richard Batch. They used to call him Putcher, as in put your dick back. Nigel, two from Nige. Thanks, Nige. I work with a ranger. Oh, sorry, a ranger who's called Biscuits because he obviously has ginger nuts. Al Sparko writes, we have a bloke at work that we call Kit Kat because he loves a break and is a little bit chunky. We've got three more. Craig Gibson, we had an apprentice who had a huge moustache. So I said, mate, you've got a huge stash of being 19. He goes, nah, I'm 18. He goes, right, well, you got a new nickname. It's Womb Stash. Thanks, Craig. And Brendan Tucker writes, we had a guy called Tim and Tom. Odd sort of a bloke. You didn't know who was going to turn up, whether it was going to be Tim or Tom. And Andy Brothwood writes, we work with a fella with one arm, so we called him Shark Bait because he swims in circles.
Oh, you got me. You got me.
Welcome to Nicknames Volume 14. My mate's bald-headed Moody Dad was nicknamed Mudguard because he's shiny on top and shitty underneath. Thank you, Chris Sinclair. Dave McIntosh has sent us one saying, my old man worked in the shipyards back in the 80s and 90s with a guy nicknamed Houdini. He was useless and always went for long ciggy breaks. When my old man asked him why his nickname was Houdini and if it was because he's always disappearing, he goes, nah, Dave, that's my name, Houdini. Just complete coincidence. Got a nickname for the apprentice that we had. He was nicknamed Dora the Explorer because he'd never take his backpack off and would be completely lost without his map. And one final one today. I work with a bloke who hasn't had much luck with the ladies despite having plenty of trying, so we call him Olive Oil because he's extra virgin. Thank you, Hayden Montgomery.
I worked with a guy nicknamed The Cherry. Apparently his old man used to wear those really short tennis shorts to the pub, and as he sat down on the pub stool, his nuts would pop out the bottom, so his mates named him Plums. So when my workmate was born, he was given the nickname Cherry. That's from Chris Faber in South Africa. We've got a mate that breaks out in hives when he gets really angry, so we call him the Red Hulk. Andy Rawson. We had a lad in school called Baghdad purely because he forgot his bag once and his dad dropped it off for him. I don't even remember what his real name was.
Oh, that's brutal.
This one here. I work with someone who only has her bottom row of teeth. So one lunch break, she bit down too hard on her food and it was as if her bottom teeth got stuck in the top row of just her gums. From that day on, she was called Ziploc.
Ziploc. Yeah.
Paul Francis with this one. We had a set of twins who played footy at our local club. One was 6'5", fit as and covered in muscles. The other one was 5 foot tall and had zero endurance at all. He was known as the dribbly bit. As his brother got the full load from dad, all he got was the dribbly bit at the end.
The dribbly bit.
This one here, though, from Carla. I call my partner the wonky donkey because he's not right in the head and has a massive dick.
Some beauties. This is Nicknames Volume 15. I got a mate called Spermy because his last name is Banks. Thanks, Adrian. We're off to a good start. There is two brothers on a different shift at my work, and we call them Tinfoil and Alfoil because one is slightly thicker than the other one. Thank you, Aaron Crow. This is from Hugh Carson. My old man's nickname was Bomb Square, a scare. When you met him, he talked so much he couldn't get away, so everyone runs when they see him. I work with a guy called Marite Eye. He was missing his right eye after a nasty car accident into a power pole. So ruthless. I used to work with a truck driver who moaned about his truck all the time, so we called him Naomi, which is I moan backwards. Called my manager the winter wading pool. Because she's cold, shallow, and although she may have been useful once upon a time, no one knows what they're doing in the room now. And one final one from Tom Tom. We work with a fella over here in Perth who's so tight he wouldn't shout if a shark bit him. His nickname is Whispers because he never shouts.
Welcome to Nicknames Volume 16. I had a work colleague who was late to work every day, so I started calling him the After Dinner Mint. He said, why are you calling me that? Because you only turn up after 8.
Like a treat from the 90s, eh? Bust him out, little peppermint sliver.
Anthony Doherty says, I worked with a bloke called Back Fatter, because every time he went on holidays, he came back fatter. We had an opening bowler for our cricket team. We found out he only had one testicle from a childhood illness. So his nickname was FBO for the 5-ball over, because he was always one ball short for every over he bowled. We had a mate who needed a dump in the middle of the night whilst guarding the Great Windsor Castle.
Wow.
He perched his cheeks over the wall and did the deed. The next morning, as we left, we seen his deposit clung onto the wall halfway down. From then on, he was known as King Klingon. Too many people can say they've done that.
The Rock, taking the piss since 91.
Welcome to Nicknames, Volume 17.
I've got a friend. His colleagues call him Bisto, which is British gravy, because he's rich and thick. Dave White messaged in, my contribution for this segment is one for my old boss. We called him the Seagull, because every time he comes in, he makes a hell of a noise, steals our chips, shits all over the place, then F's off, leaving us to clean up his mess. Anthony Negro, we had a guy at footy that had red hair, so we called him Sauce. He hated the nickname so much he dyed it black. So then we started to call him Soy Sauce. Try this one on, fellas. Used to play cricket with a very unattractive man who got the nickname Fern, because ferns have got no roots. Lockie Ellis, we used to work with a guy called Chris who had a lazy eye. His nickname was Chris Cross. Got a mate called Two Skin, because he's only got half a foreskin. Very prominent swim coach nowadays. We've got a pair of workmates we call F Cup because they're big tits that need support. Matty Johns, we've got a guy at work called Nose. He loves it because he thinks that we thought he was really smart, but it's because he knows F all.
Oh my gosh.
Phil Hayes, I know a bloke called Tenter because his fat guts push his feet out with signalling 10 to 2 like on a clock face.
His guts push his feet out.
We've got a dude at work who's nicknamed Jabba the Hutt. He's a big, fat, slimy bastard and always tries to get a co-worker into something like a golden bikini. My wife's best mate's little brother got the nickname Crunch Pants because when they were younger, he shat his pants with us sitting at the bus stop. Aaron Kiggins. Hey, boys. Love the nicknames. We've got a supervisor at work who gets on the junk and cooks himself every weekend. Mondays are always fun, and we call him the Master Chef.
Always cooking.
I was in the surf club with a bloke with a congenital chest defect. His sternum was in... His sternum was inverted, so we called him the pirate because he had a sunken chest.
That's like you! After your operation!
Oh my gosh! You buried treasure, mine was on the outside. Right, I'll park it there.
My partner's got his nickname when he was younger at the pub. They wouldn't serve him another beer until he had a can of Sprite, so he scaled it back and carried on drinking. This carried on a few more times, and later that night he decided it was a good idea to have a scrap. So proceeded to fight all the people at the pub, like Mike Tyson. Henceforth, the nickname Sprite Tyson. I call my mates Mrs. the Clown Car because she keeps popping out kids. Kirk Moon writes, we've got a guy at work called the Whisk. The weekends he sees his girlfriend, he always comes back absolutely beat. Richard Barden writes, I work with a guy we called Seaweed because he's so ugly even the tide won't take him out. And David Brown says, we've got a mate we call Carpet because his girlfriend walks all over him. And one final one. And a bit of a throwback to the very first one we ever did. My husband works with a fat, miserable prick that looks like the Michelin Man. He's called the Sniper's Dream because even with your eyes closed, you wouldn't miss him.
Oh, shit. I missed these. I really did miss these.
Oh, man. What a treat. Nicknames Volume 18, and we got a plenty.
I know a guy who's loaded and always buying expensive shit, but he's good at nothing, so he's called the Kardashian.
I work with a guy here called Spray Paint because his name was Matt Black.
We worked with a guy called Mrs. Mac because his skin was so flaky. It was like a Mrs. Mac sausage roll.
Gave this fella the nickname Sponge at a work training gig. He thought it was because he soaked up all of the stuff we had to learn, when in fact it was because he was a dirty, scraggly old piece of cloth that reeks.
We worked with a guy back in my British Army days who had a double barrel surname, so his nickname was Two Dads.
One of our players was a police officer and not very tall, so we called him Laptop, as he was the smallest PC.
There's a bloke at school we call Beanbags because one day he fell over, didn't have boxes on, and his balls popped out of the hole, hence the nickname. My mate worked with this fella they called the Moth because whenever you're having beers at night, you'd have to turn the lights off to get him to piss off.
We all know a Moth. We all know a Moth.
The Rock, taking the piss since 91.
Welcome to Nicknames Volume 17. Oh, no, it's 19. Let's go again. We call this bloke at work the terrorist because he hijacks every single conversation. This morning, it was the mere mention of condensed milk that triggered a half-hour unsolicited mountain biking yarn. This one from Waddy. I know of a guy and his workmates call him Satellite. When I asked why they call him Satellite, they said, oh, he's just always floating around. No one really has a clue what he's actually up to. Tim from Ipswich in England. I work with a guy we call the broken pencil because he's pointless. I've got a mate I used to play rugby with in Scotland. He was a hooker and his nickname was Thinky. He was as wide as a thumb and as short as a pinky. Thank you, Andrew Kirk. This is a savage.
Thinky.
We had a friend whose nickname was Mumbo because his mum had BO. No other reason. It's stuck for over 20 years now. That's from Paul Kirkby. Mumbo!
That could be the roughest yet.
Yeah. My boss calls me Clutch because I'm always slipping and not fully engaged. Andy Briley. I used to work with the guy we called Lamppost because he was 6'9" and had a 24-inch waist. Work with a weathered old bloke that had so many lines on his forehead, we called him All Thread, like an all thread bolt.
It's just a thread the whole way.
I know a mate whose nickname is Two Stroke. Two pumps and a pull and he's all done. Shortly after my wife fell pregnant with our fourth, some guys at work started calling me the broken sofa because I can't pull out.
Little beauty!
Little beauty! Welcome to Nicknames Volume 20. It's from Daniel Tucker in Queensland. Worked with a bloke who was short and very fat. We called him Circumference because he was almost a perfect circle. Zach Corbwell said, so I was playing local footy and a player's nickname was Ice. I asked another player, why do we call him Ice? He goes, well, because his cricket average is below zero. Jake Wakefield writes, we had a boss with a massive gut who still thought he had a 28-inch waist. His belt was under that much pressure that we used to call him Ratchet Strap. We've got a guy at work, he's been divorced 4 times and getting married again. We call him GST because that when this one leaves him, that's all he'll be worth. We had a lad working with us who literally keeps the local vending machine company in business. Cans of Coke, chocolate, anything he can get his hands on. Recently started on the potato chips. So now we're calling him Tupac because that's how many he gets through at each tea break. That's from David Watley. Thanks, mate. Mark Jones writes, I work with a guy who talked non-stop. We called him Sidewinder after the heat-seeking missile because once he was locked onto you, there was no getting rid of him. Thanks, Mark Jones. We have a mate with the nickname MasterCard because he's always taking credit for other people's work. This one from Harry Wellington. A bloke at my local golf club has the nicknames Pigs because his name is Mike Fly. Pigs Mike Fly. And this one here from Andrew Graham Harris.
Pigs Mike Fly.
I went to uni with a guy whose name was Dog Nuts because his eyes are really close together like dog's nuts.
My friend Brian recently lost his eye, so we now call him Bran. I also had a bloke that I worked with. Oh, no. I also worked with a bloke called Pastry because his mum worked at a bakery.
And then one day he failed a random drug test due to cannabis smoking. Since then, he's now known as Puff Pastry. It's from Noel Powell. Charles McLeod, give us this one. There's a dude that works here on the rigs in Taranaki called Hole Punch. When we were doing a permit, someone asked him to bite down on the paperwork so he could file it because he's missing four of his top middle teeth. This one here from Paul in England. I'm in the police and my team regularly does night shifts. One guy called Gary is always falling asleep. We call him the sundial because he's useful during the day but does F all work at night. Sam Fires, got a bloke at rugby called the muffler because the prick is always exhausted. Oh. Adam Bayford, I work with one lad on site who stood over a manhole whilst it was being unblocked. The drain rods flicked up. The drain rods flicked up and now he's known as Shitbeard. And finally from James in England, I work with a bloke we called Catty, as in catapult. After he dropped his overalls to have a crap in the hedge, he didn't tuck them under his feet far enough, and he finished, pulled up his overalls, and catapulted warm shit down the back of his neck.
Good visuals on that one.
Time for Nicknames, Volume 21. Luke Yates writes, there's a mechanic in the middle of WA whose surname is Sandercock, so my mates came up with the nickname Gravel Dick. We had a bloke at work called Brake Pad. Anytime he got a bit worn out for the day, he'd start squealing and whinging.
That's good.
Pat Coverford says, when I was growing up in Australia, a mate of ours was a shocker for getting fried airs on a night out, so just wandered off without letting anybody know. We ended up nicknaming him the Wok due to his non-stick nature. Michael Keem says, we once worked with a guy called Cold Sore. No matter how much shit you put on him, he kept coming back. Anthony McBride from Melbourne, Australia. Thank you for your message. I used to work with a young dude whose boss was the boss's godson. He was always stuffing up and never got in trouble. So we called him the platypus because he was a protected species. Then one final one from me. Andrew Adams from the UK says, we had a boss called the hostage, as every time someone called him, he was tied up with something.
Here's some more. Steve from England. We had a guy at school whose feet were set on fire in a gas fire explosion, so we called him Roast Pototos.
I so wonder where that goes. That's good.
Lee Hamilton, our mate's called Pipe. I thought it was because he has a massive downstairs. Turns out it's because his first name is Dwayne.
Dwayne Pipe.
James yes. Lamb. I knew a guy with the first name Hunter, but he is a vegetarian, so everyone called him the Gatherer. I went to school with a guy called Andrew who was missing a few digits on his hand, but everyone called him Godfrey. So I asked, why do you call him that? And they said, well, he's only Godfrey fingers. My old supervisor at work we called Fetter because he always crumbled under pressure. And finally, Martin Willerton. I work with a bloke who has a lazy eye, so we call him Prison Eyes because one's in jail and the other's on bail.
I still like them. Yeah. Nicknames, Volume 22.
We used to know a guy who clearly didn't wipe his ass properly. He would always have two fingers up there itching it and squinting his eyes.
Two fingers.
Two fingers. So we named him Twix. Oh, choppy fingers, eh? We lived next door to a family called the Richards. They had triplets, two boys and a girl. The oldest one we called Big Dick, the next boy Little Dick, and the girl Dickless. Thanks, mate. We named my cousin Boobs. He loved them so much he got himself a pair. Thanks, Ryan. I don't know if that's implants or just moobs.
I reckon moobs.
Yeah, moobs, baby. Hey, they're all good on you.
Yeah. My mate is called Richard William Hindmarsh. His nickname is Dick Bill Bumswamp. Lawrence Meikle. I work with a bloke we call the Paperboy. Every morning he's got a new issue. Sean in Michigan.
That's clever. Very clever.
I like that.
I call my mate Daylight Savings because his nose is so big it's an hour in front of him. Trent Harmer. I went camping with the boys and one of the lads went to take a crap. Halfway through, he heard a hissing sound. So he jumped up and ran. We nicknamed him Forrest Dump. Run, Forrest, run. Thanks, Jay. My buddy had a neighbour with a bad limp, and when he walked past the wall, he dipped up and down. We called him the elevator.
Oh, he goes up and down. Yep. Yes. My grandfather got the nickname Lotto because each time when we go fishing in the tinny together, there's a big red ball that comes out of his short and sits on the sea, says from Daryl Shelton. So we have a mate at work called Umi because every time you ask him to do something, he replies, who, me? And one final one. This is my favourite. This is from Lockie Nimmo from Brizzy. We went to school with a bloke who managed to get hit on the top of his head with a shot put when he was about 13. And he had the nickname Puddles because every time he had a shower, the indent would turn into a puddle.
Oh, tequila shots, eh? Shots out of that thing.
Take one out of the bowl, big herb. Welcome to Nicknames Volume 23.
I used to work with a lad we called Cliff after a seagull landed on him during a climbing trip. It then proceeded to shit down his back, so now we call him the Plasterer's Radio. I secretly call one of my crazy girl mates the tow truck because the bitch is always headed for a breakdown.
Oh, brutal. Yeah.
My uncle liked to party and a few sherbets, so his nickname was the Exorcist. Not because he was religious at all, but because every time he left a party, there were no spirits left.
Oh, thirsty boy!
It's an F from Russ Arnold. I had a guy I used to work with and we called him 65 Degrees because he was always leaning on stuff and never doing anything. Stephen Nedwich had an old workmate that we called Feathers because he'd flap his gum so much, if he had feathers, he'd bloody fly off.
Well, that's good.
Ian Simpson. My brother's nickname at school was Skitty. He thinks it's because his first name is Mark. But his mates tell me it's because he used to have shit stains in his pants when he changed for PE.
Well, those years later, it's just still sticking.
We work with a bloke who's rather short, so we call him Nasal Spray. You know, like Optrovin, because he's a little squirt that gets up everyone's nose. This one here from Ali Murray. There's a couple of truckies we work with. The older bloke's called Stu, and his son started recently driving for the company as a driver as well. So his nickname is Casserole because he's a little stew. And one final one from me. I used to call my granddad Spider-Man. Not because he's a hero or anything. It's just he has a lot of trouble getting out of the bath.
Visuals on that one are on point. Just started a new job and there's a guy here called the Floater. How do you get the nickname the Floater? They said because all useless turds float. We had a colleague called Bill. His nickname was Liability. He was a liar, his name was Bill, and he had no ability. Very clever, that one. I'm nicknamed the Cat. People thought it was because of my cat-like agility on the football field, but in reality, if I go near birds, they scatter. Harry Ayton writes, my mate's nickname is Lance Armstrong because he cheated on his girlfriend. We call our workmate Jellyfish because he's got no brains and he's bloody painful to deal with. Then we've got a mate called Mortine because when he turns up, everyone is repelled instantly. And one. Nicknames Volume 24.
Got a driver on my site. His nickname's Mirrors. Is any time they went to see him with a problem, the response was, I'll have a look into it. He's an absolute flop of a fella. I'm English born. My old man is Scottish and is a standard in England. He was called Jock. I had no idea why the whole footy team called me Strap until I was like 18 years old. For F's sake, love you blokes. I was in the school first 15, got rucked in the face and got needed to get 2 stitches and a scar down the middle of my nose. So I was forever known as Ball's Nose. Later, that was elaborated to Hans Ball's Nose Schmidt because of my Dutch heritage. My boss is called the Singlet because he's always on my back. Thank you very much, Ian Shaw. That's another one here from Mick Bradley in Australia.
Tagging a singlet to this.
Used to call a workmate Mud Crab because he had a full body, big arms, and his eyes were really close together. We also had another bloke nicknamed the Prawn because he had no guts, no spine, and a head full of shit. A friend of mine grew up with a boy that they called the Biscuit. He got hit by a car in his teenage years, so then they started calling him Crumbs. Guy I worked with a number of years ago, sadly no longer with us, we called Badass, which he thought was a great nickname. Here comes Badass. He thought it was a bit of a badge of honour. It actually stood for big and daft and smell sweaty. Cheers, Dave Evans. We had a bloke at work who'd usually... We had a bloke...
Here we go.
We had a big bloke who usually stunk his shirt. One day he was bent over and his shirt lifted up. You could see that he had shit smeared from wiping his ass all the way up his back. So from that day on, he was known as the Shitback Gorilla.
Yuck! Sort it out, mate.
There's a big pull through.
Got a mate called Shit Shirt. Got the name from a camping trip we all went on. He got pissed, needed shit, had no dunny paper, just used a shirt. Now he's called Shit Shirt. So I used to work with a guy called Onions. Every time he showed up on site to drive the digger, you'd cry because he's so slow. You'd be there all day. A place I used to work at, there was a woman that worked in the HR department. Her name was Kay Moffat. She was known as the motorcycle accident. Tom Brownrigg.
Kay Moffat.
Kay Moffat.
Amazing.
I worked with a bloke called Supercharger. He bloody loves it. But the real reason for his nickname is because the second he starts working, all you hear from him is the whining. Well, you work the bloke called
Yes.
It's time for Nicknames Volume 25.
Here we go.
Can I just say, word of warning, some of these are deeply personal. Shit to be you if you get read out.
I used to work with a guy who wouldn't really do his job properly. So behind his back, we gave him the nickname Zeus. Not because he was built like a Greek god, but it was a code word for zero effort unless supervised. We got a guy who comes into work and the boys call him Two Pies. I asked, why do you call him that? Because you can't get that fat eating one pie. While serving in the military, I worked with a guy called Fatal because he was fat and his name was Al. I know a guy with one testicle. He's got two kids, so we call him Powerball.
Oh, that's good.
An old friend had nerve damage in his face, so... Right, I'll save you a bus on the seat to hell. An old friend had nerve damage in his face, so he had one eyelid half closed and one really wide. So we called him Dip and Dazzle.
Oh, that's terrible.
We've got an apprentice at work known as Wonder Boy. He thought it was because he's so great and the eighth wonder of the world. Really, he has that much time off, we always wonder where the F he is. A bloke where I used to work was called Gav. He'd always bunk off early, so his nickname became Heartburn, because when the boss always asked where he was, everyone would say, Gav is gone.
Gav is done. Yeah, good.
A lad I knew in the Navy was called the Pringle Thief. The Pringle Thief, because he had had an accident and lost two fingers, so his hand can go all the way to the tube now real easy.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
I don't know.
That's one of the all-time greats. James just texted and saying, oh my gosh, these are absolutely ruthless. We had a nickname for an old boss. He used to tell us how good the jobs were that he was sending us to, but they all turned out to be nightmare jobs. Because of this, we called him Willy Wonka, because he used to sugarcoat everything. Kyle Turner has a workmate called the Seat Cover, because he just sits in the ute all day collecting dust. We work with an old weathered painter who was so sunbaked he was all wrinkled, had no moisture in his body. His name was Colin. Enter the Coltana.
Coltana is amazing.
Dan Wallace, we had an apprentice nicknamed Matchstick for two reasons, because he was pale as a ghost and had red hair, and he was also actually once known to set himself on fire during work experience. My mate is called Daryl, but he is fat, so we call him Barrel.
Couple of pork chops copping it in this round.
We're
of
about
nicknames.
To run into nicknames, volume 26.
Mate of ours is called the Squid because he got into a fight walking home from the pub one night and shit himself mid dust up. Literally shit himself. I used to work with an apprentice who got cancer removed from his throat, which left a real mint scar which went right under his neck. We called him Pez. So the Pez dispenser, flip heads. I work with a bloke who was 5 foot tall and called Anthony. He got the nickname Shetland Tony.
Oh, there's still so many good ones out there.
On a camping trip, one of the girls shat her sleeping bag. She got the nickname Shit Burrito. I have a mate with a big nose who thinks he knows fucking. He thinks he knows everything. So we call him Nostradamus. We used to work with a guy called Daisy because some days he shows and some days he doesn't. We have a boss at work who has eyes that look in opposite directions. The boys call him the tennis umpire because he doesn't need to take his eye off the court. The boy I used to work with, we called him Kickstart because after an accident he had causing a leg injury, every time he walked, his right leg would kick out in front of him. I had a friend with the nickname Three Knees. He had a left knee, he had a right knee, and he had a face loaded with acne.
Man, these are getting so wild.
Used to play rugby with a fella in the UK. One week I couldn't play, so he filled in for me at fullback. Turns out he made a real bad tackle and had his head in the wrong place, and he broke his neck in several places. Ambulance, hospital, traction for a couple of years, full halo around his sleeve with the nuts and bolts hanging out of it. We nicknamed him the coat rack. We all have nicknames in our motorbike group, but the best one by far is Fluffy Dice. He was filtering through traffic on his 125 many years ago in our college days and wasn't wearing any safety gear. A brand new Mercedes switched lanes and my mate wasn't looking. He went straight into the back of this car and flew over the top of it, and in doing so, somehow managed to split his trousers straight down the middle and his plums fell out. The landing was like a belly flop directly onto the front of the car with his coin purse resting on the windscreen in full view of the driver and his mortified wife, just like Fluffy Dice. Went to school with a guy who had the nickname Nugget because on a school excursion he ran up to the front of the bus, dropped his decks, chucked a brown eye and tried to fart, but popped out a nugget instead. It rolled on the floor and down to the stairwell. He's been called Nugget ever since. Worked with a chef, quite a big bloke. He was pretty happy with his nickname of Thor. Little did he know that it was actually spelt T-H-A-W because everything that he cooked came out of the freezer. Oh, master chef. I have a mate that's about 6'4", skinny as a stick insect, and rides motorbikes. As he's so skinny, when he wears his helmet, he looks like a chupa chup. That's his nickname. My friend's brother works with a fella who is always telling lies about how much he wins at the bookies, so they call him the Lion King. Bloke we know has a wandering eye and gets called the substitute teacher because he can't keep his pupils in line.